Hello. In this video, we will be talking about Apache Airflow components like DAG, operators, tasks, but most importantly, in this video, we will be talking about bash operator. Before we begin into much details, let's talk about what is DAG. So DAG stands for Directed Acyclic Graph. It's actually a combination of set of tasks or a group of tasks, or you can say this represents the set of tasks that make up your workflow. And it actually consists of the tasks and the dependencies between tasks. So before we dive into further details, so you can, I have open and written down a simple DAG for you that, you know, that is using bash operator. Now, you can see here that I have written different tasks, and task is actually the instance of an operator. An operator is basically something that on which you can, you know, like bash operator, the system on which the program will be running on. It can be Python operator, or it can be some Kubernetes operator. So there are other operators that we can use, but in this video we will only be talking about bash operator. So first of all you have to do is, you know, from Airflow you import DAG, and from Airflow dot operators you dot bash, you import bash operator, and these are some of the date time or other utils that you can use. In a DAG, first of all, there's a DAG ID that you can define, that this is a unique DAG ID, and then what are the arguments. So here I'm just, the arguments are owner is Airflow, and the scheduled interval we will see in another video how you can define this interval, what are the statics and what do they represent. But this video is specifically about bash operator and tasks. So now you're see that in a DAG we have certain, I'm defining two tasks. Task one is, first task is you just run a bash command, which is echo one, and the DAG which it kind of consists, or you will be using, or the configurations you will be using is this DAG. Right, so the DAG is equal to this DAG, and the task 2 is also a bash operator task, and you're seeing that the task ID is second task, and in the bash command I have written echo 2, and the DAG I'm using the same. Now there are two things, one is upstream and downstreaming. Upstreaming is basically something before, and downstream something after. So this means that first task has to run before the second task. So this symbol represent that this task will be, so you can imagine or take like the open side of this symbol, or the open mouth of an alligator is towards wherever the mouth is open, the task will run first. So task one will run before task two. Or you can even write this in this way. Task two is basically an upstream, and downstream, and then there is a task one that is actually an upstream, that it will run before task two. Task 1 will run before task 2. That is a very brief introduction about. So now once you're done with that, you have to copy the file and you have to place it to your DAGs folder. Once you place it there, it will take some time to load, and if you see the DAGs folder, and let's search out by DAG ID, we can simply by different tags. We can search the DAGs, and the DAG name that we defined in was test_bash_operator. we will search, and you see it's there. Now you are seeing that the ordinary Airflow last run was this time, and this is the schedule that we defined here. And so let's run it. So once we trigger the DAG, it will run. And we can see the tree view or a graph view, or graph view is a good way to see. Now you're seeing that the first task run before the second task, right? And if you go into the logs, so you will see that the first thing that ran was the echo one, right? And then the code exits. This was a brief, you know, discussion on bash operators. You can use any bash command here, and then you can configure multiple task IDs and graphs. And you can use multiple operators. But this video was just for the give you a brief introduction about bash operator tags and how you can use task and define task, and you can run your job through Apache Airflow. For such videos, if you like this video, please like, press the bell icon so you don't miss any of my video, and I will come up with the next video. Thank you so much, and hope you all stay safe.